to all. Today we are going to discuss about the reported speech. It is of unit 5, grammar exercise, reported speech. Okay. Reported speech. There are two main types of speech. One is direct speech or indirect speech or reported speech. The another name of the indirect speech is reported speech. The direct speech repeats the exact words the person used. How we remember their words? Direct speech is actually what the person they are speaking. That is a direct speech. Reported speech is how we represent the speech to the other person or what we ourselves say. Okay, reported speech means it is a conversation held. So speech, how we represent the speech to the other one. நம்ம பேசினதா மற்றவங்கள்ட்ட சொல்கிறதுக்காக எனது ரிப்போர்ட்டட் ஸ்பீச், இன்டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச். ஓகே, ரீட் த டிஃப்ரெண்ட் வேர்க் ஃபார்ம், தே ஆர் மே ரிமைண்ட் த சேம் இன் த டைரக்ட் அண்ட் இன்டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச். த ஃபாலோயிங் கேசஸ் ஃபில் த பிளாங்க்ஸ் வித் மிஸ்ஸிங் இன்டைரக்ட் ஸ்பீச் இஃப் த ரிப்போர்ட்டட் ஸ்பீச் இஸ் இன் த ப்ரெசன்ட் டென்ஸ். ஓகே, ஐ எம் என்ஜாயிங் மை ஹாலிடே. Kiran is telling, Krish is telling that he is enjoying his holiday. சரியா, அதை நம்ம சொல்லும் போது மாற்றிடுவோம். அப்படி தானே, கிரண் சட் ஐ எம் என்ஜாயிங் த ஹாலிடே. அண்ட் ஹவு இட் வீ வில் கன்வே, கிரண் சேஸ் தட் ஹீ இஸ் என்ஜாயிங் ஹிஸ் ஹாலிடே. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட்டு, ஐ வில் நெவர் கோ டு ஒர்க். ஓகே, தென் கவி சேஸ் தட் டேஷ். ஓகே, ஹியர் வி ஹாவ் டு ஃபில். She, Kavi, already they had written, Kavi says that, okay, I will never go to work. That we have to change into reported. She, I will change into would. I would never go to work. I would never go to work. Okay. When we report a universal truth, while reporting a universal truth, something that is always true. The sun always rises in the east. Sun never rises in the west. Likewise, the Asia is the largest continent. Okay, likewise. Asia is the largest continent. Balu said that the Asia is the largest continent. We won't change anything. People in Africa are starving. Starving means they are dying because of the hungry. Pasiyala saapadukal adu starving. So Alisha said that is given in a book. Alisha said that okay, people in Africa are starving. So how we have to change said that people in Africa are, we have to change into where starving. People in Africa were starving. Next, with the modal verb would, might, could, should, ought to, used to. I might go. Shalini said that she might go. I would try it. Vinod said that he would try it. Okay, so Vinod said that he could try it. He would try it. Okay, the next one. With would rather had better. I would rather fly. So Chitty said that he would rather fly. I have better go. So Sophia said that. Shall I rub this three? Sophia said that they had. Sophia. Said that they had better go. So they had better go. In if class or time class, if I tried my dirtied my room, my father would be happy. Shriram said that he dirtied his room, his father would be happy. When I was staying in Madurai, I met my best friend. So Zahir said that Zahir said that he had met his best friend when he had been staying in Madurai. Okay, next the sixth one. We do not usually change the modal verb must or needn't, but must have become had to and would have to, or needn't have could become didn't have to, so wouldn't have to. If we want to express any obligation, would or wouldn't have to are used to talk about the future obligation. I must wash up. She said that she must wash up or she have to wash up. Must or have to. Likewise, we must do it in the June. So he said that he must do it in June, or he had to, they have to, sorry, he had to do it in the June. Okay. Must or had to. So he must do it. Must or we can use he had to. We can use this to anyone. Must or had to. To do it in June. Instead of must, we have to use have to. Okay. So this is exercise which is given to you in your book. Before that, before doing this, we will have a recap of this direct and the indirect speech. Okay. So already you know very well about what is direct and what is indirect speech. So before that, before entering to the topic direct, indirect or reported speech, we have to know what are the different types of sentence are there. Okay. So there are four types of sentence. One is a declarative, imperative, interrogative and exclamatory. Okay. Declarative is in the form of the statement, interrogative is in the form of the question, and imperative is in the form of the command or the request, and exclamatory is always in the form of sudden expression, expressing the feeling or the sudden emotion. That is the exclamatory. So the first and the foremost, we have to find the sentence belongs to which type. Okay, according to the sentence, there is a change in the formation of changing the reported part. Okay, if the given sentence is in the form of statement, for example, I will explain you for your simple this is like a recap. For example, Ravi said, I am learning English. Now, okay,
I am learning English now.
So this is a direct speech. This is a direct speech. So this direct speech is divided into two part. Okay, where the speaker and the listener is there, that is called reporting speech. Okay, where the dialogue is said, that is reported speech. Okay, so this Ravi said it is a reporting part. And where the dialogue is said, that is called reported part. Okay, just you have for simple way, the plain way, I will tell you. Speaker and listen, where the speaker and listen is there, that is the reporting part, and what the dialogue they said is the reported part. Okay, so then by next step, we have to know what type of sentence is used there. So I am learning English now. It is a purely, it is a sentence of declarative. Okay, affirmative sentence. Sorry, a statement. So we had find out what the sentence it is given, what is the type of a sentence it is given there, that is a statement. I am learning English now. Okay, so from this, the next step we have to do, we have to find the reported part. Okay, we have to change this reported part. If the speaker and the listener is there, then the word will join. If there is no speaker or listener will be there, there won't be any changes. Here Ravi said, only speaker is there, no listener is there. So Ravi said to Rahim, for example, if I write Rahim, Ravi said to Rahim. Okay, so speaker and the listener, if speaker and the listener is there, what happened? This set will not change. It is set only. If you say, then there won't be changes in the reported speech. That also, this is a direct speech, this is indirect speech. Okay. Next, if it is set to, if the speaker and listener are there, we will use this word set to, then we will change this into told. Okay, say to, then we will change this as a tell. Says to, then we will change this as a tells. Okay. So one, in the case of set and the say, there won't be listener, only the speaker will be there. Okay, there we will use set and the say. If the speaker and the listener, Ravi said to Rahim. Okay, Ravi says to Rahim. So if it is said to, we have to use told. If it is say to, we have to use tell. If it is says to, we have to use tells. Okay, so here Ravi said to Rahim. So Ravi told Rahim, not told to. One, the whole set to, we are changing into told. Okay, so we should not write told to, we should not use it. Then Ravi told Rahim. Using this two sentence, we have to join. For that, we will use the conjunction that. In Tamil, we have to say that is a conjunction word, joining word. So Ravi told Rahim that I is a subjective pronoun. Okay, all the subjective pronoun will change into, all the first person, second person will change into third person. Okay, respective third person. Okay, see, for that you have to know the pronoun. Just now at the last class we had studied about the 10 types of pronoun that you have to forget. Here it's a different. Here we are going to learn the subjective objective pronoun. So I, we, you, he, she, it, they. Okay, these are the subjective pronoun. I and we are the first person, you is the second person, and he, she, it is the third person pronoun. Okay, so this is a subjective pronoun. So next one is a objective. I, me, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, it, they, them. This is a subjective. Then the possessive pronoun. My, our, your, his, hers, its, their. This is a possessive pronoun. So we have to see I is in the subjective first person.
So we have to write the respective third person.
We should not write this I for him.
This is objective. Puridha?
Subjective irundha subjective la dhaan paakanum. Objective irundha objective. If it is me, then we can go for him or her or anything. Okay. Here I.
Then I is a common. So who is the speaker there? Ravi. So he is a boy. So according to that, he.
Then Ravi told Rahim that he.
We had changed the pronoun. Okay. Next, present tense will change into past tense. Past tense will change into past participle.
So I, what is the past form of
am? Was. He was. This is a present continue. So we are going to change this in the past continue. I was. He was learning English. This now will change into then. That is a table. Now will change into then. This day will change into that. Today will change into that day. Okay. The next yesterday, the next day, tomorrow, the next day, or the following day. So there are thus, ago, so forth. So many words are there that I will give you the column. There you have to learn how to change this now into then or this into that. Okay. That is a mandatory rule which is given there. So this is how we have to change. First, if it is a statement, we have to check the reported part and we have to write the suitable word according to that. We have to join the both the sentence using that, and the first person change into respective third person, and the present tense will change into past tense. Past tense will change into past participle. That is, this is how we have to change the direct into indirect if it is given in the form of statement. Okay, if it is given in the form of question, if it is a WH question, we can use as it is. If it is a yes or no question, we have to use if or whether. Okay, then it is a imperative sentence, then we have to find the verb. Before verb, we have to write to. Okay, open the door. Teacher said open the door. Teacher's command or request, advice to open the door. Okay. For example, teacher said, close your book. It is in the form of imperative. So how we will write? Teacher instructed. Now teacher had given the instruction. So teacher instructed, which is the verb here, close. So before that we have to write to close. Your book will change into our book or their book. Okay, the students, their book. How's their book? Enga book na our book. Avunga book na anadhu their book. According to the meaning, we have to change. Okay. Raju said, what are you doing? How we will change this into state in reported part? Raju, question means asked. Raju asked. If it is WH, we have to use the question word as chosen. What are you doing? What he was doing or we were doing. He was doing. We have to change the sentence into, we have to change the question into statement. So likewise we have to write it. This is how we have to change the direct into indirect. You already you had studied, even it is just for your recapitulation. I hope you had understand how to change the direct into indirect. Okay. In the book, read the following dialogue and reported it. So Johnson and the Suganti both are conversing each other. Johnson, what are you doing here, Suganti? I haven't seen you since June. So next, Suganti had replied, I have just come back from my holiday in Ooty. Johnson, did you enjoy it? Suganti, I love Ooty and the people were so friendly. Johnson, did you go to Crocker Walk?
Sugandhi, it is my first trip. I can show you some picture. Are you doing anything tomorrow? Johnson, I must arrange a couple of things, but I am free today. Sugandhi, you might come to my place. At what time shall we meet? Johnson, I will be there at 8. It is all right. Johnson asked. Now they had conversation. This converse we have to convert into reported part. Okay. So what is Johnson? What are you doing here, Sugandhi? I haven't seen you since June. So Johnson asked Sugandhi what she was doing there. What she was doing here will change into there. Now will change into then. So what she was doing here. So this we have to change into there. Okay. Next. And he, then, I haven't seen you since June. And he said, he had not seen her since June. The same, he had not seen her since June. Sugandhi explained that she had just come back from the holiday. So Sugandhi, I have just come back from the holiday. So here we have tried. She had just come back. Other thing they had given, come back from the holiday. Next, Johnson wondered if she had enjoyed it. So she had enjoyed. She had enjoyed it. Sugandhi said, "I love Ooty. All the people were so friendly." So she dashed Ooty. She loved Ooty. Love will change into loved Ooty. And that the people dashed so friendly had been the people. Had been so friendly. Okay. Johnson wanted to know if she had gone to a Crocker walk. Sugandhi said that it had been her first. It had been her first trip. She would shown him some picture, and then she asked him if he was doing anything the following day. Tomorrow means the following day. He was doing anything the following day. Johnson explained that he had to arrange a couple of things. Had to arrange. But he added that he was free at night. Sugandhi suggested that he might come to her place. Must will change into might. Might come to her place. Come to her. To her place. Next, They would meet. Johnson said he would be there at 8, and finally he asked if it was all right. So I will read once again. You check whether your answer is right or wrong. Johnson asked Suganti what she was doing there, and he said he had not been seeing her since June. Suganti explained that she had just come back from the holiday in Ooty. Johnson wondered if she had enjoyed it. Suganti told him that she loved Ooty and that the people had been so friendly. Johnson wanted to know if she had gone to the Cracker Walk. Suganti said that it had been her the first trip and that she would show him some picture. And then he asked him if she was doing anything. Johnson explained that had to arrange a couple of things. But he added that he was free at the night. Suganti suggested that he might come to her place and ask him at what time they could meet. Johnson said he could be there at 8, and finally he asked if it was all right. Okay, so you check your answer. Then the next one, tick the right choice of the indirect speech which is given there. He took my English book. He was curious to know who had taken his English book. So the B one is correct, you mark. Where does Helen live? Jim wanted to know where Helen lives. Okay. Why do volcano erupted? She wondered why volcano erupt. A one. Do you know why she is unhappy? He asked me if why she was unhappy. He know why she was unhappy. Okay. How many photo could you got? He wanted to know how many photo I have got. So the first one is had taken his English book, that is a B one. The second one is where Helen lives, that also B. And some she wondered why volcano erupt, A. Fourth one, he asked me if I know why she was unhappy. How many he wanted to know how many photos I have got. Okay, so the fifth one is D. Fourth is also D. Mark in your book. I hope you had understand what is the reported speech. Okay.